Hello students, good morning to all of you. I myself Vinay Kumar. Yesterday I had given you the introduction about the chapter Ishwaran the Storyteller and also about the theme of the story as well as about some few lines about the author. Now, today, I am going to start the chapter Ishwaran the Storyteller. It means my focus only will be on the chapter today. So, let me start. Firstly, I read out the stanzas, paraphrase, and then with the difficult words, I will teach you. One night, Mahendra woke up means got up from his sleep and saw a dark cloudy form, means an image which appeared dark, and it was full of cloud. Now he broke out into a cold sweat, means he feared having seen this form or this image. Was it a ghost? Now this is the question. So when we read it, then we find the answer. The story was narrated to Ganesh by a young man, Mahendra by name. He was a junior supervisor in a firm which offered on hire supervisors at various types of construction sites, factories, bridges, dams, and so on. Mahendra's job was to keep an eye on the activities at the work site. He had to keep moving from place to place every now and then as ordered by his head office. From a coal mining area to a railway bridge construction site, from there after a few months to a chemical plant which was coming up somewhere. He was a bachelor, his needs were simple, and he was able to adjust himself to all kinds of odd conditions, whether it was an ill-equipped circuit house or a makeshift canvas tent in the middle of a stone quarry. But one asset he had was his cook, Ishwaran. The cook was quite attached to Mahendra and followed him uncomplainingly wherever he was posted. He cooked for Mahendra, washed his clothes, and chatted away with his master at night. He could weave out endless stories and anecdotes on varied subjects. Now I come to the difficult words which I have prepared, which will be helpful to you to understand the story. You already know Ishwaran the Storyteller, the writer is R.K. Lakshman. Now come to the difficult words. A story means tale, narrated means to tell a story, junior means lower in rank, supervisor means observer, firm means company or plant, sites means places, construction means making building, keep an eye on means watch, mining means digging, bachelor means unmarried, odd means different, ill-equipped means lacking facilities, makeshift means portable, quarry means open mine, meanwhile means at the same time but in another place, attached means related, uncomplainingly means without any complaint, Posted means appointed. Chatted means gossiped. Weave out means prepare. Anecdotes means short narrative facts. Varied means different or several. Now come to the paragraph. The story was narrated to Ganesh by a young man, Mahendra by name. Students, there was a person whose name was Mahendra. He told the story to Ganesh. He was a junior supervisor in a firm. Mahendra was a junior supervisor in a company or in a plant, which offered on higher supervisors at various places, types of construction sites like factories, bridges, dams, and so on. And Mahendra, who was a junior supervisor in the company or plant, he supervises the various places where the work was going on related to the making of buildings, factories, bridges, or dams. Mahendra's job was to keep an eye on the activities at the work site. The duty of Mahendra was to keep an eye means observe the activities or work which was going on the work site or workplace. He had to keep moving from place to place every now and then as ordered by his head office. According to the instruction, direction of the head office, Mahendra was going from one place to another place. And there were different places like coal mining area to railway bridge construction site. And from there, after some time, he goes from there to the chemical plant where the work was continuously going on. Now further, there he was a bachelor, no doubt, means Mahendra was unmarried. So due to his unmarried life, his needs were very simple, means his needs were a few. And that is the reason he was able, means he was capable of adjusting himself in different kinds of conditions, all kinds of conditions, whether the building will be ill-equipped, already know the meaning, lacks in facilities, or a makeshift canvas means temporary shelter. Tent in the middle of the stone quarry means where there were a lot of pebbles. But there is a matter of very happy that he has an asset, and the asset was his cook, and the name of his cook was Ishwaran. And Ishwaran was a cook. The cook was quite attached, means he was absolutely related to Mahendra, and without any complaint, he used to consider the order of Mahendra or junior supervisor. The cook was absolutely related to Mahendra, and he followed, means Ishwaran followed without any complaining, what were the instructions which were given to him. And he was posted means appointed. So Mahendra was appointed different places. He cooked for Mahendra wherever Mahendra went. Ishwaran also went there, and he used to cook for Mahendra. He not only cooked for Mahendra but also washed his clothes, and the most important was that he chatted or gossiped with his master Mahendra in the night. And Ishwaran would also prepare so many stories and anecdotes on the various or different subjects. So this way Iswaran was a very unique person who was related to Mahendra. Now today for this exchange 1 and 2, next day I start the next paragraph. Thank you for today. Next day I start next paragraph. Thank you.